welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. The show presents the National League Division Series. The Atlanta Braves, the St. Louis Cardinals. John Ciambi, Chris Singleton with you. And as we get set for Game 5, Chris, it seems like this series could still have a few twists and turns in it.
Yeah, and even though neither team's going to be going home after today, Game 5 always has the feel of an elimination game when the series is tied up at 2-2. And maybe it's just as important as one, because being up 3-2 as opposed to down 3-2 makes a huge difference going forward.
Yeah, you don't want to be the team with their backs up against the wall in Game 6. This is a big swing game. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. All right, just about set to go. And on the hill, Jake Woodford.
Well, you don't always know what to expect with this guy on the mound to start the game. He can be really good at times and turn in some real excellent efforts. For me, it'll tell us a lot to see how he's attacking the strike zone and pitching aggressively or not. If he's doing that from the jump, I think he'll be fine in this one.
So just about set. Here's the veteran outfielder, Eddie Rosario. A wind in the pitch. That one close, ruled a ball. And a count 2-1. The wind of the pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. And here it comes. And that one fouled off. Next pitch is outside. And he deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. Ball to strike. And that's outside. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. The other way. And foul ball. Rosario gets his lead at first with nobody out. Two now. Line to left. And now maybe extra bases. Rosario around third. Cut off. Now a throw home. The tag out.
A lot of real estate to cover on that play defensively. A long throw to the cutoff man. And then a lot of ground to make up as well on the relay. But an excellent job of execution and getting that out at the dish as he tried to make it home all the way from first base.
Matt Olson up to the plate. Man at second. Ball. One out and a runner at second. Line drive, base hit. Ozzie flying around third. The throw in, but it's offline. He will score. And it's 1-0.
Well done. Drives in the run. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video, because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Here's Marcelo Zuna. and a pitch. In the air, out towards left center. Makes the grab. Nice play after the long run. Two down. Throw, and it gets away. Here's Austin Riley singing game five at elimination spot, and the spotlight is focused on this guy.
Everybody looks to the star players in big games like this, and this is what you get paid for. Time to come through. I think it's huge that they were able to score right away. You're playing on the road. Stakes are high. Energy in the ballpark, and you help to quiet that down a little bit.
This ball's chopped on the ground. And no throw. He's into first easily. First and second, two down. Adam Duvall at the plate. 1-1 now. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Two outs. Swing and a miss, and that is that. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 1-0. We go to the bottom of the first, and on the mound in this one, Tucker Davidson.
Well, he doesn't have overpowering stuff, so it's important that he finds his rhythm early. I think the easiest thing for him is to trust that catcher. Catcher's been in the league a long time. He knows these hitters. Whatever fingers he puts down, you nod the head and you throw that pitch.
Bottom of the first. Here's a speed threat, Tommy Edman. The pitch. Bouncer to second. Albies to first. And they get Edman for the out.
Batting second. The first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt. One down, base is empty. Smash to the left side. Throw on to Olsen. And they get Goldschmidt for the out.
Batting third, the left fielder, Tyler O'Neill.
Here's Tyler O'Neill. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field. And that extends the inning. That ball was absolutely ripped. 111 off the bat. And I'm pretty sure it started to whistle after it left the bat.
I think I heard that too, Boog. And these are the moments we appreciate when we can look at StatCast and just see exactly what the data is. Always so much fun to see what numbers pop up.
Here's Nolan Arenado. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Tosses across to first. And they get Arenado for the out. And that is the inning. The Cards leave one. They trail here 1-0. Top of the second. Dansby Swanson stands in.
Swanson, former first-round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff. But really coming into his own.
Yeah, the right-hander deals. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Pretty good spot on the outside, but just couldn't quite clip the zone. That's a stone-cold take.
Here's Dickerson now. Swing and a little roller right side. Goes to second for one. Back to first. Double play.
For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn on the infield. The first baseman has to get inside, create a throwing lane to hit that middle infielder to start the double play, and then from there, completing it back to first. Really good job all the way around.
Two outs, base is empty. Next to hit, Travis d'Arnaud. Ground ball, left side. Over to Goldie. That's out number three. After an inning and a half, it's 1-0. Back here in St. Louis, bottom half of inning number two. Now it's the right fielder, Dylan Carlson. And a pitch. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and that's the first out.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
Here's Albert Pujols. The 1-1. That one missed. Just missed. Dave Lawrence assigned to work home plate in this one.
Good umpire, Boog. Very fair, very consistent. Now, I did hear some feedback that he opens up the outside corner a little bit on left-handed hitters, which, you know, for me, I'd be kind of salty. So maybe something to keep an eye on and see if that factors into this one at all.
Three, two on the way. Rosario, long run on his horse. 3-2. The punch out there. That's the second out.
No, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Now Molina at the plate. Is lifted in the air. Duvall on the move to the alley. Pulls it in on the run. And that is that. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They're down 1-0. Back here at Busch Stadium. Now it's going to be Eddie Rosario. One ripped. That drops in, plays it on a hop. Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. In the dirt. And an excellent job keeping it right there. Pitch and delivers outside. Here comes a pitch, rocketed out towards right center, and that's a base hit. Carlson with a quick throw back in, and it's now first and second to start the inning.
Wasting no time, he's 2-for-2 now on the night, and just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. And now Matt Olson up to hit. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. And it is 2-1.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Rosario, the lead runner at second. Albies at first with no outs. Liner caught at second. So here's the cleanup hitter, Marcell Ozuna. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. The pitch. And a foul ball. Righty to the plate. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Here's a 1-2. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Right through there, got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Austin Riley next up for the Braves. And a 1-1. And another ball.
Count to 2-1.
The count 2-1. Rolled over to third. Arenado to first in time. And that is that. Two left for Atlanta. They lead it 1-0. As we go to the last of the third. Now it's Paul DeJong up to the plate. Lefty ready, and a 1-1. Pulls that one foul. Swing and a high fly ball in the air left field. Dives, but it falls. And now it looks like extra bases. Safe at second with nobody out, and he represents the tying run.
Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
And now Bader up to the plate. Here's a 2-1. And that's in for a strike. And now the lefty, swing and a miss, and he's down on strikes. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
Second baseman, Tommy Edman.
Now here is Tommy Edman, a switch hitter batting right. Runner leads away at second. That's to third. Fires across the diamond, and they get Edman for the out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. So the tying run at second, and there's a ball. The 2-1. And that's in for a strike.
Good pitch to hit on a tee up in the zone. I think he was looking for something else right there.
Next one off the plate inside. 3-2 now. DeYoung stands at second with two gone. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
So now two on and two outs.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just miss the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
Here's a 1-1. Good eye right there.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
That's towards center. Back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. So the Cards strand a couple, still behind by a count of 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, here's the center fielder, Adam Duvall. The wind of the pitch. And now two balls and a strike.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
The wind to kick the pitch. And now 2-2.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Well, that's the money maker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, that's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes, and very difficult to lay off.
And now the shortstop, Dansby Swanson. One, two now. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Now he breaks his bat. Goldie. Out on a bang-bang play, but he made it close. Two outs, base is empty. And next for Atlanta, Alex Dickerson. He hit into a double play his first time up. And a 3-1 on the way. And he walked him.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Next pitch misses inside. Ball two. Action in the St. Louis bullpen. Johan Oviedo getting ready to go. Righty delivers. Next offering is outside.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
Swings and misses, and we're filled up.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitters got to stay focused on the pitch.
Come backer to the mound. Over to Goldie. And that's the third out. Braves strand one, but they lead it 1-0. of the inning. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Nolan Arenado. The 1-1. That's a bullet, but it goes foul. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. On the ground, right side. Albies. And a quick out, number one.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, with just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Kicks and fires. That's in there. And the pitch. Lined, and that's a base hit.
That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
And now it's Albert Pujols' turn to hit. The 3-1. This to center field. Duvall should have this one. And there's two down.
The catcher, number 4, Yadier.
And stepping up to the dish is Yadier Molina. 0-for-1 so far. Carlson leads off first with two down to the inning. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. And here it comes. And he flips a breaking ball in there, or a changeup.
Either one, something off speed. Good arm action on it, whatever it was.
And now it's filled up.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
At the belt and fires. Line drive, base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock.
First and second, two outs. Paul DeJong now at the plate. The pitch. Turned on, but foul wide of third.
Well, you put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
Next one misses, and it's 2-2.
They tried to get him to go, chase the pitch down and away, but he wouldn't bite.
Kicks and deals. And that one in the air center field. Duvall in position, makes the catch, inning over. So a young arm coming on now out of the pen, Johan Oviedo. And he'll do his best to keep this close.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And welcome back. New inning getting started. Now in for the Braves, Eddie Rosario. Next offering is in the dirt. Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. That one felt good, and they add a run. It's 2-0.
see how he stays square to the plate. He takes a breaking ball that's away, gets around it, gets it up in the air, and hits a long home run. Not exactly the way that you teach it in the cage, but you'll take the result.
So now to the plate for Atlanta, Ozzie Albies. This guy has turned into a beast. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
And it's even up.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Next pitch just misses. Full count 3-2. And he deals. Lined into right. Dives and makes the catch. So a great diving catch, and that was only possible because of the route he took to get there, right, Chris?
Yeah, StatCast shows us just how efficient that route to the ball was. In fact, that's about as good as it gets, pretty much a direct line to it. And perhaps he was a wide receiver in a different life, I don't know, but man, great job to hold on all the way through the dive as well. No fumble caused by the ground.
Now all even up. Foul ball there. The pitch. Now a screamer into the outfield. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Here's a 1-1. And it's fouled away. That one misses in the dirt. That's down and in. Two down, nobody on. And that's ball four.
They just keep handing out gifts, Boo. Were we supposed to bring something?
Singy, I think just our presence is the present. And now, Austin Riley. Here's a 1-1.
That's a ball. The count, 2-1.
And that's a strike.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
And a pitch. And that one ripped to left and makes the grab. And that is that. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. And it's 2-0. Welcome back. John Schauby with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Harrison Bader. And a pitch. And that one pulled foul. And a pitch. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. Way back there. And out of here. Harrison Bader leaves the yard. And they're on the scoreboard. It's 2-1.
pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Tommy Edman at the plate.
Oh, he's just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Next offering finds the zone of the count is full.
Count is 3-2.
That one the other way. Gets it to first. And they get Edman for the out.
Up next to the Cardinals, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
And up next for St. Louis, Paul Goldschmidt. The 1-1. Liner stabbed at first. Tyler O'Neill, next up for the Cardinals. Great speed and great power. A great athlete, quite simply. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. Stays alive. The 2-2. Popped up left side. Riley makes the catch, and that'll do it. One for the Cardinals on the solo home run, and it's now a 2-1 ball game. Back here at Busch Stadium. And now the center fielder, Adam Duvall. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for him tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in a game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him, make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
And the batter now, Dansby Swanson. Next offering is foul back. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Well, that high four-seam fastball has become such a staple as a strikeout pitch over the years. And what's so tough as a hitter is that you see it extremely well. The problem is the velocity at spin rate just happens to jump by you. You expand your zone, you don't stay tall on the backside, and you're really not even able to make contact. If you do, many times it's a pop-up.
Now it's Alex Dickerson falling behind 2-1. The wind and the pitch. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. That's down. One hops off the wall. Dickerson into second, and he's got a double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Man at second here with two away. And now it's Travis d'Arnaud at the plate. Right-handed reliever. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
Dickerson over at second. Darnold on at first with two down. Late swing, foul to the left. Right side, hard hit. Edmund slings to first. Third out. To the bottom of the six we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Braves 2 and the Cardinals 1. Tyler Matzik will take over on the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Bottom of the six. Now up the Cardinals' number four hitter, Nolan Arenado. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. The 1-1.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
Hammered, and now maybe extra bases. And that's going to get into the corner. Swanson, relay to second. Not going to get him. He's in there.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. That ball was drilled 106 off the bat, and that's the kind of feedback that tells you you're right where you want to be with your swing mechanics. Now a pretty big at-bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
This is Dylan Carlson. Here comes a pitch. And that one missing low. Two down. High in the air, out to right. Rosario on the move, heading back. Back some more. Grabs it on the run. Runner tags up for third, and he makes it up to third with one away.
Now batting, the designated hitter,
Albert Pujols, getting ready to hit.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
A strike. That one catches the corner for a strike. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Luke Jackson preparing to come on if needed. The 1-2. Got him! Huge strikeout there.
Well, this is where the team aspect really comes into play on the offensive side of the game, right? I mean, missed opportunity to tie it up with the runner at third, one out, couldn't put the ball in play. So now it's time to pick him up. And that's where good teams, they go to. They operate on this level of next man up. That mentality is what causes them to win series, get into the postseason. That helps keep the energy and morale high in the dugout.
So Luke Jackson gets the call. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Yadier Molina. Next pitch downstairs. And that's ball two. And that's downstairs and outside. And the right-hander's 3-1. Ripped towards third. That one's sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Runner from third comes across. It's 2-2.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Paul DeJong. Next offering misses. Now two balls and a strike. And the righty deals. That one fouled off. The 2-2 now. In the air, left field. Ozuna drifts towards it. Makes the catch. And the inning is over. Yachty so clutch for the Cardinals. And we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Nick Wittgren. So digging in, Ozzie Albies. The pitch. And now 2-1. Swing and a tapper. Now the throw to first on the run. One up, one down.
Now back the first baseman, Matt Olson.
Here's Matt Olson.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
The 1-1. Slice the other way. That's a base hit.
The left fielder, number 20.
One down, runner at first. Now the Atlanta cleanup hitter, Marcell Ozuna. Next offering is foul back. The pitch. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. One away, tie game. Go ahead run stands at first. Stays alive.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
And a 1-2. And that one upstairs.
I got to count 2-2.
Kicks and fires. That misses, and it's 3-2.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Swing and a foul, pushed off to the right, and that will get out of play. Three, two. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. One away, tie game. Go ahead, run stands at first. Got him. Two down.
Unafraid to throw it right there. That's trust in your stuff. Just one out away from getting out of a huge jam.
And next for Atlanta, Austin Riley. Righty delivers.
Oh, that's out.
Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. The kick, the 3-2. Line drive. Oh, he gloves it.
Making it look easy at the Keystone position. Definitely worth another look. He'll get some high fives when he gets into the dugout.
Here comes A.J. Minter to the mound. Now pitching for Atlanta, number 33, A.J. Minter. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now at the plate, Harrison Bader. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. Out to short. And Bader is set down.
The batter number 19, second baseman, Tommy Edman.
Now, Tommy Edman. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Swings and misses, and it's 1-2.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss. Out number 2. Paul Goldschmidt digs in now.
Well, he's always a threat. Even if this guy is 0-for-3 for the night with 3 strikeouts, he can come up that fourth time and do damage because he's that good.
And a 1-1. That one missed. Pitch. That one fouled off. 2-2. That misses off the outside edge.
Really good take, especially with 2 strikes.
Three balls, 2 strikes, the count. Hit in the air, right field. Rosario settles underneath it. And that will end the inning. And down in order go the Cardinals. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the 8th. Jordan Hicks. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. We go to the 8th. Now in for the Braves, Adam Duvall. One one now.
Duvall, one strike.
A little bit low.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
And he deals. And that's through there for a strike.
Helpful.
3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
And he reluctantly takes his walk.
Go ahead, run on base. And here is Dansby Swanson.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position.
And a swing and a miss. And that is a big first out.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're...
Over to Edmund. What a double play that was. Inning over.
Poetry in motion there as the second baseman turns the double play. Nice throw to first, and that's the way to end the inning.
Now here's Darren O'Day to take over for the Braves. Right-hander who throws from the side, really almost down under. Bottom of the eighth. Now up for St. Louis, Tyler O'Neill.
Now this guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Looked like it was a little bit up. Chris, when you take in a stadium, I think one of the things that I always contemplate is, where are you? And in St. Louis, Busch Stadium, you know exactly where you are with the arch in the background. They mow it into the lawn, the gateway arch. Basically, it goes from line to line and out towards center field, and then the retired numbers, the championship banners. I mean, it really shows off the history of this proud franchise.
Yeah, Boog, and this city is always just covered in red, especially during the baseball season. But they've added that ballpark village out there in left center field. Very accessible to come into this city, stay downtown, get to the ballpark, and take in a game in a great setting.
And here it comes. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Here's Nolan Arenado.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. So now one and two. Movement in the bullpen. Will Smith getting loose out there. The next pitch misses, two and two. Righty to the plate. Stays alive. Looking. One gone to the bottom of the eighth.
Boog, he was shopping at the buckle right there, the way that slider made him look. That was just nasty.
Number three, Dylan Carlson.
Dylan Carlson will hit next. Could be extra bases, and that gets all the way to the wall. Runner around third on his way to the plate. Oh, he throws it away. The tag, and he's out trying for three, but they do grab the lead.
The triple is arguably the most exciting play in baseball, and a guy's worked so hard to get around first, to get around second, to get thrown out at third. man, you just feel bad for him. On top of that, he was already in scoring position, so you think about how it kind of hurts the team as well.
And now, Albert Pujols. Next offering upstairs. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Boom, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. At the bullpen is Will Smith, and his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Two outs, runner at first. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. And a count 1-2. And that one lifted in the air center field. And Molina is retired. And that will end the inning. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. We're on to the ninth now in game five. It's the Cardinals 3 and the Braves 2. And now they turn to Giovanni Gallegos, trying to protect this lead. Back here in St. Louis, and here's the catcher, Travis D'Arno. The 1-1. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss. One and two here. Got him looking. And one out now.
Well, the first batter, it's always a big one for the closer. I mean, you get that punch out, you get settled in, you feel like you're in command out there on the mound from the jump, and kind of prevents any doubt from creeping into your mind or the guys that are playing behind you that, you know, you're going to wrap this thing up.
Next offering is in for a strike. One run game here at the top of the ninth. To the right side. Oh, great stop. Fires to first. Nicely done for the out. Ozzy Albies next up for the Braves. Looking to get the tying run on base. In the air, left side. He's got it. Ball game. And the Cardinals hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Well, this turned out to be an exciting, very well-played game. Always feels great when you can take the lead in the eighth at home. Come on the ninth, the crowd will be behind that pitcher as he tries to get those final three outs. Everybody goes home happy with a win like this.
Not a ton of offense to chat about as we look at the final numbers, but this was a good one.
Yeah, it was a low-scoring game, Boog, but sometimes those can be the best, especially this time of year.
A 3-2 final score in this one. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.